The Danube makes Budapest. The great river cuts through the heart of the city, dividing ancient hilly Buda from modern pancake flat Pest, in a setting which inspired the music of the Hungarian composer Béla Bartók. 2,000 years ago, the Romans chose Buda as a garrison site, and after centuries of invasion, war, and revolution, Budapest has had a number of facelifts. But in the city which gave the world the Rubik Cube, as well as the music of Bartók, there's a paradox. While Budapest undoubtedly belongs to a different world, in many ways it enjoys a lifestyle as relaxed as our own. And with the cost of living only about half what it is at home, shop prices come as a pleasant surprise. Hungarians appreciate the good things in life more than most. The giant market hall is the equal of anything you might find in France. The stalls brim with fruit and vegetables, including some the unknowing should treat with caution. From the Buda side, the Parliament building, looking like a cross between our Palace of Westminster and St. Paul's Cathedral, looms large on the skyline. Some of the buildings, though, aren't quite what they might seem. The castle of Vida Hunyad in the city park is a reproduction of one in Transylvania. It was originally a prop for the 1896 Millennial Exhibition, but the people of Budapest liked it so much, they decided to rebuild it and put it on permanent exhibition. Close by, in Heroes Square, the lonely winged figure of the Archangel Gabriel looks down on the statues of the leaders of the seven tribes who conquered Hungary and on the Museum of Fine Arts. The Eastern Railway Station is a showy relic of the days of steam, and there are places on the facade for the British engineers James Watt and George Stephenson. In the castle district, the spire of Matthias Church towers over a network of cobbled streets lined with dozens of pastel-coloured buildings. Fisherman's Bastion is like something out of Disneyland. The dazzling array of turrets, terraces and arches could pass as an authentic medieval monument. But in fact, it was only built at the beginning of the century. The parks give Budapest a feeling of spaciousness, and with trees and flowers at almost every turn, it's a garden city too. The Roman Empire's elite used to escape to Margaret Island, a mid-Danube refuge, which is now a haven of peace and quiet for the people of Budapest, even if the Japanese garden is a bit run down. Back in Buda, in the shadow of the Liberation Monument, you can follow another Roman tradition, taking to the waters.
This wave pool, which opened in 1927, was the first in Europe. The water comes from thermal springs, and nowadays in summer, the waves surge for 10 minutes every hour. It's a bit like a dip in a giant jacuzzi.
Once you've arrived, getting around isn't a problem. Public transport in Budapest is both cheap and efficient, and some rides offer spectacular views of the city. The princely sum of 6p buys you a 7.5-mile ride on the Pioneer Railway. The service is run almost entirely by children, and protocol is observed down to the last salute. The line, which opened in 1948, is used by commuters as well as holidaymakers. You can virtually set your watch by the arrival and departure of the trains. Only the train drivers are adult, and any child worth his weight in paprika gladly swaps a day at school to work on it. Comfort, not time, is the hallmark of this hotel, recently opened by a French chain on the outskirts of Budapest. The rooms, all with private bathrooms, are comfortably furnished, and the hotel has a swimming pool, sauna, and a bowling alley. A seven-night package holiday here costs between £252 and £334 per person. The price includes flights, bed and breakfast, and a half-day city tour and visas. There are also weekend packages.